All right, here we are at the end of day three, and I'm currently in Enfield, Connecticut. We did a lot of interstates today and pretty much covered some extra ground in the hope of getting ahead of the rain a little bit, or just getting farther ahead in case it rains, because the forecast pretty much right down the coast talks about rain at this point, which is definitely less than ideal. But it is what it is. Can't really do anything about it. Gonna be hard. Be hardcore and manage that. The interstates weren't bad, and eventually we found our way through into Massachusetts and got on, I think it was Route 9, and that turned out to be quite a surprisingly good road when we got off the interstates. Rode it for a while, and your usual kind of backwoods kind of stuff, and you know, it was nice and all, and then come into this really crazy twisty-turny section with the trees growing in over it, and just fantastic for riding, which is pretty awesome. I'll post a clip of that as well for anyone who's actually interested in it, but that'll only be the bikers, because it's just video from the front of the bike, and it leans, and it's all wind noise. So really only a biker would be interested in watching that. So I will not bore anyone who's watching this with that. Got to a Super 8 here in Enfield, and this was pretty awesome, because if anyone who's watching this knows Winston, I pretty much have found his Connecticut counterpart, because I rolled up in the V-Rod, and that started a 20-minute conversation that began with things being American-made, and I think eventually ended with conspiracies that have to do with the government taking money from the poor people. Not sure how we got there, but it was a solid 20-minute conversation. Did end up getting us a pretty good discount on the room, I think, because I was willing to listen to the conspiracies. So, yeah, that was pretty weird, really, in the grand scheme of things. But all right, still, it's pretty entertaining. Room is fine. I'll do a quick run-through of the video again pretty soon, or of the room. Right in front of the motel is the Hacienda del Sol, which is probably the best Mexican food that I've had since I was actually in Mexico. Run by a Mexican guy and his wife, and we later found out that the only white person that works there is the cook. So I'm not entirely sure how that translates into the great Mexican food. Apparently awesome Mexican food is made by the white slave of Mexican people. I don't know. Maybe that's the Corona talking. Who knows? That's probably all the lessons learned. Went to Subway for lunch and found out that the standard Subway cheese that everybody gets there in Canada is called American cheese here. It is absolutely no different in taste, appearance, or anything else that the Canadian one is, but it has American in the name now. So, way to go, Americans. I think that's probably it. Anything else?
No.
It covers the day, doesn't it? I think that covered the whole day. Not sure what's on the go for tomorrow. I've had 3 Corona and I'm half in the bag, which I think means I haven't been drinking enough water through the days. So I will probably just go and have a glass of water and pass out. So, alrighty then.